Thanks to the cannon, the deadeye, and the spoon that we found, I believe that we're on a trail of a 1700s English shipwreck. And the shipwreck that we're tracking could be number 2, 4, 6, or 9 on the list that Gordon gave me.
Several scores of barrel hoops scattered everywhere.
The barrel hoops are an amazing clue because it tells us that the barrels sank exactly in the position that they were on the vessel. After the wood rotted away, all you're left with are the rings.
It just confirms that this wreck went from that deeper water to shallow water. So this trail's a lot longer than we originally thought.
Finding these barrel hoops is incredible. This leads us to believe that we are on a major impact zone, and that would help us find the rest of the shipwreck. So what do these barrel hoops mean? Does this mean that it's merchant ship, or does it mean it's a naval ship?
I would be leaning towards merchant ship. And the reason I say that is, I mean, we've only found the rail gun, all the barrels, the ballast, and we're not seeing a whole lot of armament yet. A military ship would have had a lot of cannon on it, and it would also have had a lot of munitions. The one little rail gun wouldn't account for that.
But it's important to note that any merchant vessel of any time period had protection.
The rail gun, the pewter spoon, and the barrel hoops lead me to believe that we may be on the trail of a 1700s English merchant ship, which means it could possibly be 2, 4, 6, or 9 on Gordon's list of wrecks. And if that's true, then we're talking a minimum of 13 tons of silver. 13 tons of silver is $4.5 million just in silver weight alone, not counting the historical value. What I'd like to know, obviously, what were they carrying? What's in those barrels? If that ship was going across and it broke apart and the barrels sank straight down, did the whole ship sink straight down? Or did it break apart? And then luckily it's bobbing like two corks in, and then all of a sudden the barrel slid out and then happened to land straight down?
It's just unbelievably weird that all of the barrels sat straight on the ocean floor and then rotted away. Given the nature of the time constraint that we're under, it's very important for us to determine which shipwreck we have here. If it's a shipwreck that's scattered over many miles, we might be out here working this thing for years and years to come. So it's very important for us to discover what kind of shipwreck we have. This way we can figure out how we're gonna go ahead and attack that shipwreck.
We're not finding material that would suggest that the ship fell all down in one spot. It's looking like it just kind of dropped some material and kept on moving.
So the question is, guys, what kind of wreck is this?
It's been, I think, most of our experiences that there's a number of different sorts of wrecks, three in general. The first one is an intact or coherent wreck site. That is a ship that just takes on so much water it sinks. Those wrecks tend to stay pretty much intact. There'll still be a lot of loss of material, but they'll all be in one place. The other one, we'll call it an impact wreck, is one that comes in and maybe plows into a sandbar or, you know, a reef line, and it'll just stop dead in its tracks, and then, you know, over some time it'll break up and you'll have a limited scatter. Then there's like the third type, fractured and highly scattered. Multiple pieces breaking off of one area, dropping bits and pieces over maybe multiple lines of scatter. We worked on one down in Panama, the San Jose, which went down in 1631. The top of it ended up going 41 miles in another direction. So we've still got to look around quite a bit.
We don't have enough information just yet to figure out exactly what type of shipwreck we're on. But the barrel hoops are a fantastic find, so we're going to continue to search the immediate area. Hopefully, we can find more related artifacts on the line that we've already established. Towing's going to help us identify targets a lot quicker. And with our expertise, it'll be easy for us to see stuff that no one would be able to see.
6 big cannon all stacked next to each other. It's amazing, but they're huge. It's 6 cannon. Now that's what I'm talking about. You think that we're not on our game? Well, this is it.
This must have been a really big ship. These cannons were built to protect something important, and something important could be treasure.
Let's go down there and get ourselves a closer look at this beauty. I will find treasure!
Freaking amazing! Oh my God! I'm definitely in the zone, dude! Oh,
my God. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Some of these larger boats could have, 20, 30 of them. Even 40 depending on the size of the boat. That means there's more to be found.
This is amazing. Yeah, it's amazing, Carolyn. It's a hell of a good time.
They're beautiful. They gotta be at least 8 feet, right?
Yeah, roger that. About 8 feet. We're probably just gonna have to leave them right here. They become part of the bottom now.
These cannons were a great find, but they're heavily encrusted and they become part of the marine environment. And it wouldn't be cost prohibitive nor very environmental to bring these cannons up.
The rest of it's gonna be somewhere.
These are all most likely from the 1700s. Everything else that the ship was carrying could be around in this very same area.
I guarantee you, if this ship has treasure, we're finding it.
Hell yeah!